The big
butt.
Thomas and Alfred were digging at the edge of the garden when the two men saw a big
butt.
Thomas tried to pick it up, but it was stuck to something.
Get off my face, sir.
So he gave it a good hard jerk, and it came off in his hand. Thomas and Alfred looked it over carefully. This will make a very good soup, but I think I'll take it home. Then the two men heard something groan and scamper away. When the men got home, the first thing they did was start the soup. Into the big soup pot went water, carrots, green beans, corn, barley, onions, potatoes,
Donald Trump,
a snitch of beef, some salt and pepper, and the butt. Yum, they said, sniffing it and tasting it. We can hardly wait till supper.
A half hour later,
Thomas and Alfred got up and served themselves some soup. That night, Thomas carved the
butt
into two pieces, and they each had a piece. Then they did the dishes, and when it got dark, they went to bed.
That night, after Thomas had fallen asleep, Alfred sat in bed trying to read. But all he could think about was
the big
butt cheeks.
How shiny and smooth they were, how thick and heavy. They were beautiful, he thought. Just beautiful.
Then Alfred thought he heard a strange voice.
The sound awakened Thomas. It was something out in the street. It was a voice, and it was calling to him.
Where is my boat?
It groaned. When the two men heard that, they got very scared.
Did you hear that? Alfred asked.
It's just somebody singing, Thomas told himself, but he was frightened.
Well, let's lock the doors, said Alfred.
That's a good idea,
said Thomas.
Thomas and Alfred heard the voice once more, only now it was closer.
Where is my boat?
It groaned. They pulled the blankets over their heads and closed their eyes.
We'll
go to sleep, they thought. When we wake up, it will be gone. But soon they heard the back door open, and again they heard the voice.
Where is my boat?
It groaned.
Thomas and Alfred were
really scared.
They
got out of bed again and piled all the furniture against the door. Then
Thomas and Alfred
heard footsteps move through the kitchen, into the dining room, into the living room, into the front hall. Then slowly they climbed the stairs. Closer and closer they came. Soon they were in the upstairs hall. Now they were outside the door.
Where is my booty?
The voice groaned.
Oh,
fuck, Thomas and Alfred
screamed. Suddenly, the front door flew open and in walked the ghost of
King Big Booty.
Where his
butt
should have been, there was nothing but a ragged stump oozing blood.
The
butt had been ripped clean off.
Thomas and Alfred were so afraid that they both
smoked 1,100
blunts. Just like that.
Or smoke weed every day.
Thomas and Alfred
looked and saw
the ghost reached out with his arms and tried to find it. The wind went
and Thomas and Alfred
shivered and shook and moaned, oh lordy, lordy.
Then they stopped.
Where is my booty?
The voice groaned.
You've got it!
Or
Thomas
is dead and
Alfred
don't know it.
Or
Alfred is dead and
Thomas
don't know it. They both are dead in the very same bed, and neither one knows that the other one's dead. Baroom, baroom. Yeah.